concussion coming off that thing standing right here.
I'm always game for trying new products. I'm talking stuff that opens up newer or additional possibilities. I introduce you to Harry's Holsters. This nifty little Kydex holster is by no means revolutionary, but it does offer some unique features. It's primarily geared toward AIWB carry, or appendix inside the waistband, also known as plain old appendix carry. So let's talk about that first. You know, that controversial shoot your dallywhacker off concealed carry position. Though this concept is a little overblown in my mind, I completely understand the mentality. It's hard to get over pointing a gun at your junk all day. No getting around it. And if it's not hitting Action Jackson, it's probably headed right toward your femoral artery. So lose-lose. I hear people say shooting that artery would be worse than shooting your manhood. I disagree. It's much better to bleed out than live without Mr. Happy. I know, I'll lay off the big Willy style references. It's just such easy material. So strong side IWB, or your more traditional inside the waistband carry, is still largely preferred these days. This ubiquitous style of carry generally places the handgun somewhere between 3 and 6 o'clock for a right-hander, and 6 to 9 for a lefty. And it works great for most people. That said, appendix carry is picking up steam, and is admittedly better in some ways. For one, the draw stroke is faster and generally more ergonomic than, say, a cross draw, or from the vicinity of your hip, as competitive shooters have largely found. Also, while sitting, as I often am in my car, at my job, or just in tight quarters, it's generally easier to reach. At the appendix, it's even easier to retain from an aggressor, as your hands naturally rest right there, and you have all the leverage right in front of you. It also conceals better for most people than other carry methods. And for many of us, full-size carry is a possibility at the appendix, as you're not going to need your winter puffer jacket to cover that bulging tumor on your side. As for pure comfort, that's going to depend on your body. For me, it's perfect, unless I'm hunched over when putting on my shoes or something like that. Then it smashes my guts. Otherwise, it's all day, forget about it kind of comfortable. So if you can avoid those situations where you're folded in half, it's hardly noticeable. If you're a little rounder, on the other hand, with a little more padding around the waist or some spare tires covering your belt, you may feel differently. But for me, it beats having your gun rub on your hip bone all day, or keeping it in a less accessible area like your back. Also noteworthy, I'm never more cautious of my trigger finger than when drawing from appendix carry. And maybe more important, equal care is taken when we're holstering. I mean, it'll make you OCD style particular about fundamentals, and you won't want to rush. And I'm talking more to myself. While editing the video, I did notice that I could improve my care when holstering the gun. At the time, I thought for sure I was using caution to fully clear that holster of obstructions, and just didn't realize how quickly I was moving. I need to slow down, cant the muzzle farther from my body, and maybe position my hips forward to clear my legs. The often promoted hard break, where you take a breath and analyze followed by slow movements, could save your life, or at least a lot of embarrassment when your video gets on YouTube and goes viral. So again, appendix carry is making me more detail oriented than it might otherwise be. And if you want an added measure of safety for appendix carry, I'm a proponent of hammer fired guns. That way you can guard from those potential trigger snags with your thumb. Either that or a manual safety could prevent accidental discharges, heaven forbid your shirt or drawstring get caught in your trigger guard while holstering. But strangely enough, all the negligent discharges that I'm aware of occurred when carrying off the hip. While I don't know of a single incident with appendix carry, I'm sure it's happened, I just don't know of any, and that might be due to lower usage rate, or maybe partly the extra care taken when carrying in this more delicate manner. So what's your priority? Greatest concealment, security and speed, or increased safety? That will largely determine whether you choose appendix or a more traditional carry method. So if appendix carry does fit your style, Harry's Holsters is great. I was recently sent this for testing, and after a couple weeks, I've been pleasantly surprised. The Kydex is thick, providing great protection for your handgun, though it's not too thick as to be noticeable inside the waistband. And that solid construction will ensure that once stowed, there's virtually no chance of trigger manipulation. It's expertly molded with attention to detail, and I'm sure it's going to last. But the coolest thing about these holsters is their modularity. They're set up to accept virtually any type of attachment, so you can carry in just that way that tickles your fancy. Holster claws, soft belt loops, clips, overhooks, you name it, you got it. And you can set it up at various cant angles or even different more traditional carry locations if you don't like the appendix. I've really grown to like running it with an old to clip combined with a claw. The claw here keeps your pistol's grip tucked tightly against your body, making it even more concealable. And the old to clip makes it easy to wear even in your afterwork grubbies without a belt. As far as angle of carry, both draw stroke and personal ergos need to be taken into consideration, and this gives you options. The retention on Harry's Holsters is easily adjusted, just like you'd see with most Kydex style offerings. And don't forget that you need to keep that thing snug. You never know when you could get into a physical altercation, even a wrestling match with the kids, or just the need to do a spontaneous cartwheel. You never know, right? And I want to be clear, I'm not promoting appendix carry over your current favorite. It's not for everyone, and has potential to be dangerous, especially for novice shooters. Just be smart, be responsible, and take your time. If you don't currently jive with the appendix hype, keep an open mind. The fanatical following of only one particular method of carry could cause you to miss out on better ways, though granted, appendix carry might not be that. Those negatives I mentioned might be deal breakers. You still get that gut-wrenching pain as you bend over and your pistol gets crammed into your stomach. It might not fit your body type, and the ever-present groin at gunpoint is unsettling. But the benefits of appendix carry deserve consideration. I still use a variety of carry styles. I feel like it should be as varied as your wardrobe, the season, or what side of the bed you woke up on. Today, appendix carry might be the boss, but maybe a shoulder rig is better tomorrow when wearing your coat. Maybe an ankle holster works better in your dress to impress evening attire, or that belly band is perfect to conceal your mouse gun when working out. I personally love pocket carry in the summer when clothes are tighter and less abundant. Sometimes outside the waistband carry is possible, and that can give you an added measure of comfort. You ladies out there might like thigh or bra carry, whatever. The point is, there is no one-size-fits-all perfect solution. I encourage people to use different carry methods and mold it to your attire and activities for the day. For me, appendix carry is firmly entrenched in that rotation, and maybe it would be a beneficial addition to yours. Whatever you choose, carry on and stay safe out there.